ఈ రోజు ఈ ఎపిసోడ్ లో సీనియర్ ఇంటర్ మ్యాథ్స్ సబ్జెక్ట్ పేపర్ 2A లోని ప్రాబబిలిటీ టాపిక్స్ గురించి తెలుసుకుందాం. ఈ ప్రాబబిలిటీ టాపిక్స్ పేపర్ 2A లో 22 మార్క్స్ కు ప్రశ్నపత్రం ఉంటుంది. మరి అంతటి ప్రాముఖ్యత ఉన్న ఈ టాపిక్స్ ని గత 25 సంవత్సరాలుగా ఇంటర్ ఎంసెట్ ఐఐటి లో అనుభవం ఉన్న ప్రొఫెసర్ ఎంవి చంద్రశేఖర్ గారు వివరిస్తారు. హాయ్ స్టూడెంట్స్, నిన్నటి ఎపిసోడ్లో ప్రాబబిలిటీకి సంబంధించి ర్యాండమ్ వేరియబుల్స్ బైనామిల్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్ థియరం గురించి తెలుసుకున్నాం కదా. మరి ఈరోజు ఎపిసోడ్లో సినాప్సిస్ ఆఫ్ బైనామిల్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్, ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ అండ్ బైనామిల్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్ గురించి తెలుసుకుందాం.
ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఆన్ బైనామిల్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్స్, విల్ బి డూయింగ్ అరౌండ్ 6 to 7 క్వశ్చన్స్. ఆల్ దీస్ 7 క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆర్ ప్రీవియస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఐపీఈ అండ్ దే ఆర్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ అండ్ ఎగ్జాస్టివ్ ఆల్సో. ఎగ్జాస్టివ్ ఇన్ ద సెన్స్ నో అదర్ కాన్సెప్ట్ కెన్ బి థాట్ ఆఫ్ on binomial distribution other than these 6 questions. First question.
Question 1.
One ship out of 9 ships is likely to be wrecked. Wrecked means damaged. Damaged on sea. When set on sail. When six ships set on sail, find first one. At least one will arrive safely. Second one, exactly 3 will arrive safely. This is a question. Now, in any question, whatever be the makeup of the question, what is the thing you have to note? You have to note that what is the success. Here, what is the probability of the success you have to calculate? What is the number of trials, n? So, what are the binomial variates? N, P, Q. If you know N, P, Q, anything of the required thing can be formed. Now, here, what is the probability solution? What is termed as success? Success is ship arriving safely is success. Safely is success. But what is they are talking about? Being wrecked, they are talking about. So, they are talking about the failure. So, Q, failure is Q. So, total 1 out of 9. 1 becomes the favorable. 1 is the favorable. And what is the exhaustive? 9. Q is 1 by 9. If Q is 1 by 9, automatically P will be 1 minus 1 by 9, which is 8 by 9. How many ships are set on sail? 6 ships are set on sail. So, N is equal to 6. What you want? First one, there are two questions you see. First one is, one ship will arrive safely. Probability of X is equal to at least one. Yes, minimum one should come. See, probability of X is greater than or equal to 1. X greater than or equal to 1 means at least one. Minimum one. That's why greater than or equal to 1. Now here, very important point is stressed upon here. What is the important point? There are two events. One is desired event. Another one is the complement of that event. Now, you can calculate either of these two. But the point is which involves more workout. If a desired event needs more workout, you should work out complement event. And after working out the complement event, 1 minus complement event will give you desired event. I repeat, the desired event and its complement. Together, probabilities are how much? 1. Now, what is to be judged? What is the criteria for the calculation of any one of these? How many how much calculation are depending. For example, if you see here x greater than or equal to 1, what you have? Probability of x1, probability of x2, probability of x3, up to probability of x6. So 1 to 6 are to be calculated. What is the complement event? Complement event is only x is equal to 0. So what are the success? What is the range of the random variable? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Instead of calculating these 6, you can calculate only for 0. And you can subtract it from 1. Probability of 1 minus x is equal to 0. So 0 success. So 1 minus 6c6 into what is the success value? 8 by 9 whole power 0. And what is the failure? 1 by 9 whole power how many? 6. 6. So this is equal to 6c6. You know it as 1. 1 minus 1 by 9 power 6. So this is the solution. First part is over. At least one will arrive safely is this. Now second part, probability of x is equal to 3. Exactly 3 arriving. So that is nothing but 6c3. And what is the success? What is the success? P, 8 by 9. You want the success to be done thrice. 3 should be the success. Then Q power Q. Q is 1 by 9 whole power 6 minus 3, 3. So this you need not simplify, because the 9 power 6 involves a bigger number. That bigger number nobody expects you to find out. Until and unless it is asked in the question, show the probability so and so, you should leave the question here itself. The answer can be left here instead of simplifying. So we have done the first part as well as second part. This is an illustration of the question in which P is calculated, Q is calculated, desired probabilities are formed. If the mean and variance of a binomial virate are 4 and 3 respectively, find P, N and probability of x greater than or equal to 1. Check. What are the given things here? The mean and variance. If you recollect our synopsis part, we were listing mean as what? NP. Variance as NPQ. These all you should have in back in your memory. Okay. So solution here. What is the given you list? NP is equal to 4. NPQ is equal to 3. Okay. This is asked for 2 marks question. Very simple question. 2 marks question. NP is equal to 4. NP is equal to 3. Now, if you divide one by the other, if you divide one by the other, for example, second equation divided by first equation, what you are going to get? NPQ by NP, which is equal to 3 by 4. If you observe, NP gets cancels out. Q is equal to 3 by 4. Q is equal to 3 by 4 will give you what? P is equal to 1 minus 3 by 4. 1 minus 3 by 4 assumes 1 by 4. P value we got, Q value we got. In this, if I substitute from 1, if I substitute P is equal to N into P value 1 by 4. If I substitute 1 by 4, what do I get? N value I get added as 16. So N is 16, P is 1 by 4, Q is 3 by 4, P value, N value, which they are asking in the question, which we have found already. Now what is left over? Probability of x greater than or equal to 1. Now recollect, we were doing the desired event, desired and desired along with rest total, not desired, not desired, not desired, total. Desired plus not desired will give you total events. Now, which events you will calculate?